Hey there, guys. Welcome to PIVX class. Today, we have the third episode of PIVX Basics. We'll be talking about privacy in cryptocurrency, as well as how it affects PIVX. I know that for people brand new to this field, this privacy stuff can seem kind of strange. I'll be helping you guys to understand why it isn't quite what people have been told. So why don't we just hop right into it? To begin with, there is a lot of misinformation out there about privacy and cryptocurrency. So you may hear things here that don't match up with what you've heard before. Unfortunately, there is a lot of both positive and negative bias out there towards cryptocurrency. There's also just so many people who don't really understand it, so they release bad information or half-baked information. I will always attempt to only give you correct information, but obviously everyone makes mistakes, and I have my own bias as well. So I encourage you to do extra research if things here seem to conflict what you've heard before. You may have heard that Bitcoin is popular with criminal organizations because it is untraceable. This is actually quite untrue. If you recall our blockchain lesson in episode 1, you'll remember that the blockchain records all transactions. If a criminal is apprehended and their Bitcoin seized, the blockchain can be used to track those Bitcoins back to see where they came from and where they go to. Bitcoin's anonymity stems from the fact that you aren't named on the network. Once someone links a blockchain transaction to you, your transactions and even how much coins you own can be traced. Is this a good thing though? Obviously we want to catch criminals, but do we want our own money to be watched like that? This can be a hot subject of debate for some. There will always be shady people wherever you go, unfortunately. But do you govern your lives around these few? Many argue that they have nothing to hide, so why worry about it? Well, my underwear isn't a secret, but do I particularly want you to see it? What if you were to be paid in cryptocurrency? Would you want everyone to know your salary? Even simple things like shopping. Do you want people to know where you eat every day, or where you like to buy your intimates? I really doubt many would say yes to any of these. This kind of info is already gathered on us every day, and I for one at least prefer that it wasn't. I hate when I muster the willpower to not buy that stupid little drone just to have it dangled in front of me in ads for the next 2 weeks. Privacy really can be for normal people. It's our choice whether we allow the criminal minority to govern how the majority of us good people live. So how do you fix this? How do you fix this privacy issue if you really want to? There are a few ways to go about it. Different cryptocurrencies have found different solutions, but the most popular is something known as the Zerocoin Protocol. Much like how interpretations of proof of stake vary from coin to coin, so does implementation of the Zerocoin Protocol. Zerocoin runs on zero knowledge proofs. To oversimplify how it works, it would be like if I put a $5 bill in a closed pot filled with many other $5 bills. And the pot keeper gave me a ticket that just said I have the rights to redeem a $5 bill. I didn't have to prove anything else, not even which $5 in the pot is mine. When I want to spend it, I give the pot keeper the ticket and say, pay it to Alice. The pot keeper takes my ticket and pays Alice with $5, but not necessarily my $5, just any $5 bill that was in the pot. This means that there is no linkage between my payment and the money Alice received. Again, this is just the simplest way to explain it, but it is how Zerocoin Protocol works in general for all currencies that use it. PIVX was not always a coin that used Zerocoin Protocol, but we added it with update 3.0.0 in the third quarter of 2017. In fact, PIVX was the first proof-of-stake coin to do this successfully. Until then, it had only been proof-of-work coins that did this. It's not even particularly hard to use them. You just tell your wallet how many regular PIV you want to mint into ZPIV. ZPIV is what we call our Zerocoin Protocol enabled PIV. You can then spend ZPIV to send someone some regular PIV. Yes, when you send ZPIV, it arrives to them as normal PIV. There are some good reasons for this, but I think that's enough for now. We'll cover exactly how to use ZPIV in a later video. The important thing to keep in mind here is that PIVX gives you the choice you can either conduct normal blockchain transactions with PIV or completely private transactions with ZPIV. It comes down to just how much privacy you feel that you need. Okay, that's all for today, guys. I'm hoping I properly illustrated that privacy can be important for everyone. I love having you here on PIVX Class, so I look forward to seeing you in our next lesson, where we'll be talking about why you might want to get into cryptocurrency. If you're still on the fence about whether it's right for you, this lesson might help you choose whether it is or isn't. Thanks again for tuning in, and I will see you next time.